Cloaks were our way of recording who we were. The way we recorded it was by incising with sharp shell and stone markings that denoted our country, our clan, our sacred sites. So that's been our way of telling story. So firstly, I looked at the foundation of AATSIS being law or ceremony. Firstly, there had to be a smoking ceremony on the site. And then I was looking at the other ceremonies, which was like the ROM ceremony from the people from Northeast Arnhem Land. And the third one that I looked at that seemed a key thing, a key point, was the ceremony for Uncle Big Bill Nedji, Kakadu Man. And so I was looking at the Lorikon ceremony as well. Across the southeast, the diamonds often represents law. And I looked at it in terms of ceremony because I had the three of the diamonds. So I looked at that as like the foundation. This is the Bunjil feathers and this is the Wa feathers or the crow. So Bunjil is eagle hawk, or what we call today wedge-tail eagle, and Wa is the crow. And I was looking at this pivotal letter that was written saying that more Aboriginal involvement should happen in AATSIS at the time and that there needed to be a new direction. Bunjil and Wa covers a lot of southeastern Australia. That's a really important letter. So I will look at the Bunjil and the Wa being half of the same coin in a way that they're both creators and their story is a creation story. So I had Bunjil transforming into Wa. This is about the native title conferences and the support for the language retrieval work that AATSIS does. And I was looking at this sort of idea of like continuing stories and the ups and downs, I suppose, in our native title battles and recognition. Yeah, this one is the fishnet. So that in the rivers in the old days, they made fishnets, and that was like publication, our stories, and the library, a chance for us to go and find our stories or find our people or even find our family stories there. And so that's sort of something that binds us together and nets us together, if you like. This one here, I was looking at the shape when I was up at AATSIS of those big discs of film, and they were different shapes, some of them, that were going on the reel to reels. That's our stories there, and stories about country, stories about families. So I was kind of looking at how they're all recorded. And the last one is like the family history unit and the photography collection, which is where a lot of us begin to access AATSIS and have contact with AATSIS. I know it was for me, is in asking for family photos and how that sort of, like a basket weave, it meshes us all together, because that's where a lot of our stories are kept together. And that's kind of critical to us as Aboriginal people coming into the organisation. Yeah, that's where we begin to have any idea of what is at AATSIS.